All right, guys, what I'm going to show you is ImageFX. This is just released. It's Google's new AI image creator, and it works really well. And it works, in some cases, better than a lot of these things that where you can get really good, very clear, very realistic images, and very easily. I'm going to show you how to do that. Now, the problem with ImageFX is it's part of the AI test kitchen at AI test kitchen with Google. And right now that's only open to certain countries. So it's only open to the United States, Australia, New Zealand, I think, and Kenya. Why Kenya? I don't know, but I'm going to show you how you can access that with from wherever you are in the world. Okay. So right now I'm in Portugal, but this account that I created is Canadian based. So it doesn't have anything to do with the US. But what you're going to do here is you're going to put that AI test kitchen. I'm going to put the links in the description so you'll be able to do this. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you why this is the best tool for beginners who want to create AI, because it allows you to guide the creation and the refinement of the images in a way that is very difficult for a lot of people in, let's say, Midjourney, not only because of using Discord, which a lot of people don't like, but in the other image tools. This really allows you to refine your image in a way that makes it really easy to get what you want if you're not an expert in AI image prompts. So let's get into it. So first you're going to sign in with Google, as you can see, not available in your country, and you can see which countries and you can get notified. And I certainly would do that. But what you're going to be able to do is you can just go on to an IP, a different IP. Now I'm using a NordVPN. You can use any VPN, but what you're going to do is it will basically put you into that country. So it can be very helpful for accessing certain restricted content on media. I'll put a link in the description. I definitely think you should check out a VPN and have one. So as you can see, now that I've just changed my VPN, I can sign in to AI Test Kitchen. All right, and let's sign in here. So here's ImageFX, and basically it gives you an example of what you want to start with, but you can start with just about anything. And what I think a lot of people struggle with the image generation is really getting something that's realistic and being able to refine. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to type with something very simple. Okay. That really is just starting out here at the basic, not really knowing what kind of vision that I want to achieve. And what's really nice about this is it will generate some images for you. Okay. And then it will give you suggestions, right? So you can actually change this to, let's say I really wanted more of, a steampunk. And this will give you some different options. And then I can even type other things in here. Let's say 30-year-old holding a book. Okay. And then it will not only generate these images, but it will give me different suggestions. Also, you can see that we've got some suggestions down here right now. So it's just generating the image, and I'll just show you right here. You can actually see some different images here. I'll wait for this image to generate, and then we'll start clicking on this. So this is completely different, and this may be more of what I wanted. And then I can actually either click some of these right here, or I don't even know what this is, but let's try that. And then I can generate. Okay. So this will continue to help me refine what it is that I'm looking for. So some of these don't have a background. And so I could say our glass in background. Okay. And then it will just keep on adding these to the image. And anything that has an option, you can actually change it. So I guess that's the type of lighting. So it can give me different lights, right? And again, I can realistic. And so I can add different elements to this to refine it and bring it really into what I want to achieve. And let's go back to cyberpunk, because I thought that was a little bit more interesting. So I can keep going through and adding different things. And what's lovely about this is it just gives you these elements that you can add to it. And it understands in natural language what it is that I'm looking for. And then I can see variations of that. And so you can see that it's generated six image sets. And so I can go back and see some of these other ones, but you can see how it's evolving. And then I can even do type things like portrait or something that's more close up. And this is what's really cool. Now, as you can see, you can actually download any of these images. You can go back to them. I really like that. Not all the AI generators allow you to easily go back in and see all your ones easily. And you can download any of these images. So if I wanted to download this, I can copy the prompt, okay? Or I can copy the image. I can download it. And again, what's nice is it has a lot of this in the title of it. Just from a metadata perspective, if I go back and want to recreate something like this, then, you know, that would be easier for me to do because it's in the file name, right? So you might have longer file names, but it can allow you to really dial in what it is that you want. You can also share this if you want, and you can adjust these different things. So let's actually put it onto like a scar tattoo. So you can be specific about what you want with that. Also, what I love about this is you can also say words in background caution. Okay, so this can actually generate words that are readable in the background. And as you can see, as it generates this, it does generate. So sometimes it's not perfect, but you can see there's a little bit of kind of caution. Let's change that. So the words in the background, yeah, that didn't really turn out well because it wasn't really sure what those words are. Caution. Okay. So we'll try that. Now, you can also adjust the seed, right? So this only applies to future outputs. So basically what this is, it's like a randomizer character. So if you find one that you've really dialed into, then what you can do is, and see, these are all a little bit different. And so if I wanted to maybe do this one here, choose this one, then I can actually lock that and then generate similar ones just based on that, which is pretty cool. And I'm not getting the words in the background. Let me try if I can do this again. Yeah, it's not getting in there. So this almost has it like smoking. No, yeah, but it's grabbing it with pamphlet type of thing. All right, so it looks like I've hit my daily limit with that. But anyhow, I hope I've been able to explain a little bit about ImageFX and how to access it and how to create great images that are really easy to generate and a whole lot of fun.